Friends, today let us learn a very interesting topic from Indian Express Explained, where are hot springs and Gogra Post, what are their strategic significance? China, according to the source, informed India that it should be happy with what has achieved regarding the disengagement in the Xiangzhong area. During the 11th round of discussions between the senior military commanders of India and China on April 9, to resolve over 11-month-long standoff in eastern Ladakh, a top source who had been involved in decision-making told the Indian Express that China had refused to vacate two of the four original friction points. China, according to the source, informed India that it should be happy with what has been achieved regarding the disengagement in Xiangzhong area. At two friction points, patrolling point 15 in Hot Springs and PP-17A near Gogra Post, China still has platoon-level strength, each along with vehicles. What had happened here last year? In May 2020, when China had diverted its troops who had come to the Tibetan Plateau region for their annual exercise towards their line of actual control in eastern Ladakh, creating a standoff with India, PP-15 and PP-17A were two of the four points where the soldiers were eyeball to eyeball. The other points of friction at that time were PP-14 in Galwan Valley and the north bank of Xiangzhou. Chinese troops had crossed the LOC at all these points and positioned themselves across. The maximum ingress was on the north bank of Xiangzhou, where the Chinese troops were at Finger 4, which is 8 km west of Finger 8, where Indians say the LAC lies. What are the PP-15 and 17A? Along the line of actual control between India and China, Indian Army has been given certain locations that its troops have to access to patrol the area under its control. These points are known as patrolling points or PPs and are decided by the China Study Group. CSG was set up in 1976 when Indira Gandhi was the Prime Minister and is the apex decision-making body on China. Bearing certain areas like the S Bank Plains, these patrolling points are on the LAC, and troops access these points to assert their control over their territory. It is an important exercise since the boundary between India and China is not yet officially demarcated. PP-15 and PP-17A are two of the 65 patrolling points in Ladakh along with the LAC. Some of these 65 also have an additional Alpha PPS, which are further ahead from the original PPS. So PP-17A is different from but close to PP-17. PP-15 is located in an area known as the Hot Spring. So I'm repeating again, PP-15 is located in an area known as the Hot Spring, while PP-17A is near an area called the Gogra Post. Where are these two areas? Both of these are close to the Chang Semo River in the Galwan subsector of the LAC in eastern Ladakh. While Hot Spring is just north of Chang Semo River, Gogra Post is east of the point where the river takes hairpin bend, coming southeast from Galwan Valley and turning southwest. The area is north of the Karakoram range of mountains, which lies north of the Xiangzhou Lake and southeast of Galwan Valley, which became a major flashpoint and a violent face-off in June 2020 had left 20 Indians and at least 4 Chinese troops dead. What is the importance of this region? The area lies close to Konga Pass, one of the main pass which according to China marks the boundary between India and China. India claims of the international boundary lies significantly east as it includes the entire Aksai Chin area as well. During the official negotiations on the boundary between India and China in 1960, Yang Su, who had the Tibet Bureau of Foreign Affairs in the Chinese Foreign Office, had stated that the western sector of the boundary is divided into two portions. The Konga Pass has the dividing point and the portion north of Konga Pass is the boundary between Xinjiang, now Xinjiang, and Ladakh, and the portion south of it is that between Tibet and Ladakh. Thus, hot springs and Gogra Post are close to the boundary between two of the most historically disturbed provinces of China. How significant are they for the military? Both PP-15 and PP-17A are in an area where India and China largely agree on alignment on the LOC, which comes southeast from Galwan Valley, turns down at Konga Lake and moves towards An Pass before reaching the north bank of Bangso. China has a major post of People's Liberation Army a few kilometers east of Konga La, which Indian posts lie southwest of it. However, according to the official history of the 1962 war between India and China, the region is not yet identified as a major launch pad from where an offensive can be launched by either side. The official history notes that China had succeeded in eliminating possible launch pads for an offensive against the Aksai Chin Highway by eliminating DBO, Chosul and Dem Chok positions. It said that all the more strengths the contention that Indians should have attempted to retain at least one jump off point, Chosul. But the history notes that Hot Springs was an important post even during the 1962 conflict. In October 1962, there was a company strength at the Galwan post, while three other posts, Hot Springs, Nala Junction and Petrol Base, had strengths of a platoon. Hot Spring also served as the company headquarters and was shelled by Chinese on October 21. Chinese troops had wanted to get behind Hot Spring but were registered at the Nala Junction. What is the situation now? As two of the four initial friction points during the recent standoff disengagement of troops from PP-15 and 17A had started in June 20 during the initial rounds of discussion. Both sides had agreed to disengage from PP-14 Galwan Valley and PP-15 and PP-17A after the third round of meeting of the senior military commanders in June following the Galwan Valley clashes. However, though China pulled back its troops from PP-14, it did not complete the disengagement from PP-15 and PP-17A. While earlier there had been a company-sized strength at both these locations, there is still a platoon each there, along with military vehicles. After the disengagement in the Shangsong region, when both India and China had pulled back its troops and armored columns in February, as per the agreement, the senior military commanders were to meet to discuss the other friction points, including these two and Epsang plains. However, no fresh ground could be broken in the talks, and China has refused to pull back. Thank you.